Welcome to IGM Guru. IGM Guru is one of the global leading online training and certification provider for IT expert by the skilled IT gurus to help them achieve their professional goals.
Let me start with my introduction here. My name is Rajiv Kumar. I'm actually having 14 plus years of experience in this industry, managing multiple aspects of cloud there, so including public cloud, private cloud, and obviously providing the consulting work for different kind of organization. Having overall all kind of certification specific related to cloud and the security. So normally managing security aspect of most of the organization specifically from the cloud there. Let me just give you one of the brief overview about what exactly the CCSP course is all about. So when I'm talking about the CCSP course, which is called as the Certified Cloud Security Professional course. So in the, this particular certification course is actually from IC2, which is International Information System Security Consortium. One of the most recognized certification might be heard about previously as well there. That name is CISSP, Certified Information System Security Professional. So for the same vendor is actually for this course as well there. So this course is also from the IC2 only, and the CISSP is also from the IC2. And this certification course so far is one of the most prestigious certification in the cloud security, specifically in the management. Because we are having two type of certification when we are going for any kind of technology there. One is the technical, or you can say the testing one, and the another one is the management. When I'm talking about the testing, it means we are actually going to do the hands-on things, where we are going to work on that particular technology, where we are going to, you know, implement the things there. Like when I'm talking about the public cloud. In public cloud, we are actually going to talk about the infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, and software as a service. And in that particular area, we are going to talk about how exactly we are actually configuring those all of the things there. Like how exactly we can implement the IaaS, and for the IaaS, how exactly we can set up the network infrastructure, how exactly we are configuring our virtual machine infrastructure there and providing the proper security so I can provide the proper access to the consumers based on what exactly is required there. Or you can say the need to know and least privilege principles we are going to follow that time there. But the another aspect of any kind of technology is the management. Now when I'm talking about the management, it means before you are going for any kind of solutions within the organization, first thing you have to do a proper planning there. Without proper planning, you are actually making your organization vulnerable for so many different attacks which is right now possible around the world there. Security is never ending process there. And when I'm saying security is never ending process, it means we have to look for the security in a holistic way there. And when I'm talking about the holistic way, it means we have to look for the fine grained, or you can say the every pieces of the security which is which is actually going to include and provide a proper way to implement any of the solution within the organization there. So management is actually going to take that particular view. Management certifications are actually for those people who understand the cloud. Specifically, if I'm talking about the CCSP, the management certification, like the CCSP certification, actually for the people who actually understand the cloud, already have worked on some platform there, and now they are trying to implement the solution in some organization, might be in their own organization, and might be they are working, going to work as a consultant for different organizations there and providing the correct solution, the correct time for the correct resources there. And this is what the CCSP certification is all about. In this certification, we are actually going to talk from the scratch, like which kind of technology or which kind of service model is going to suits the organization requirement. Might be my requirement is to reduce the cost and focus on overall the applications which are there in my organization. So in this case, might be platform as a service is going to suits my requirement best. But when we are looking for more and more control over the cloud, that time the infrastructure as a service is going to suits my requirement there. So it is totally depends like how much security you require, how much functionality you require, and how much control you require. And based on that, we will be selecting the IaaS, PaaS, or SaaS, software as a service infrastructure. So in the CCSP certification course, we are actually going to discuss about those particular or those components only there. where we are going to starting from very beginning, you can say starting from very scratch there, where we are going to talk about the cloud concept and along with the architecture and the design. So in this certification course, we are having total of 6 domains to cover. Now this 6 domain is actually covering the different common body of knowledge there. That this common body of knowledge is actually, you know, seeing or viewing the different perspective. Those perspectives are what exactly the components we have, what exactly the application we have, and how exactly it needs to be published there. But before that, as an architect, as a professional, we should understand what are the different service models we have and which scenario is going to suit the requirement of my organization. So cloud concept, architecture, and design, in this particular section or in this particular domain, we will be discussing about the cloud concept, like what exactly the cloud, what are the standard definition of the cloud is, both from the ISO, which is one of the worldwide accepted standard, and obviously from the NIST side as well. Now this certification course is actually moreover focusing on NIST perspective. National Institute of Standard and Technology has given multiple guidelines and multiple standards which you must have to follow while implementing the cloud solutions. Moreover, NIST has been given there for the federal government organization, but federal government organization guidelines, which is published by the NIST for the cloud, is actually suits most of the organization requirement, and this is making it most ideal for different organization there. So we are going to discuss about from that particular perspective there. So we are going to discuss about what is cloud, both from the ISO and from the NIST perspective. What are the key attributes of the cloud, both from the ISO and the NIST perspective, and then what are the service model, what are their best features, and what are their demerits? Because obviously when we are going for the solution implementation in front of the customer, you have to talk both languages. What are the benefits and what are the demerits? And then you have to provide a single solution which is actually best suiting the requirement of the customer. Remember, this course is actually best suits the requirement of for the cloud consultants. It's going to best suits the requirement for the cloud architects. It is actually going to best suits the requirement for the cloud professionals who is actually working there and who wanted to implement a best possible standards within the organization. Because if you are deviating from the standards, again, a big loss and the big compromise can be possible there. So we are actually looking for the best standards to implement within the organization there. So we will be talking from the different perspective there, like what exactly the architectural point of view for the cloud there. If I'm talking about the SAPSA, Sherwood Applies Business Security Architecture, which is one of the enterprise architecture, you know, solution we have available around us, otherwise STOGAF as well, otherwise cloud cube model is there as well. So what exactly they are talking about and what are the key components of this architect design section we have to understand there. And based on that, I will be providing the end-to-end solution for the customers. Again, in the cloud, we are having different role, and specifically 3 roles are very, very much needed there. One is the cloud service provider, which actually provide you the solutions like Microsoft Azure, AWS, Google Cloud, Alibaba. These are actually the cloud providers. So we require a cloud provider which is actually providing you the solutions there. But to offer this solution, most of the time cloud providers are not directly dealing with the cloud consumers. They're actually giving this responsibility to the cloud brokers. So we also have to understand what are the cloud brokers available around us, who is going to provide me the most suitable options or most suitable feasible options for my organization or for the customers which I'm working for. So we have to understand the cloud broker perspective as well there, which is actually going to do the customization for you based on your requirement. And obviously this customization is going to help reduce the costing as well there. So that perspective we too are going to understand in the cloud concept, architecture, and design. And after that, cloud consumer. So what exactly the responsibility of the cloud consumer in this relationship? That one too we have to understand there. So over and all, this domain is going to provide you the foundation for all of the concepts which you require to implement the cloud solutions there, both from the administrative perspective and some technical perspective. Like when we are going on the cloud, one of the most suitable option, or you can say the security option we have, is the encryption, not only for the data at rest, data in motion, or for the data in use, but also when we are destroying the data from the cloud, if my data lifecycle is over. So how exactly those encryption solution we have to implement? What are the key management functions we have? How exactly we are going to manage the lifecycle of the key on the cloud? That one too is going to be the discussion point of the first domain. And after that, the last section of the first domain is going to discuss about the some of the best standards we have to implement. Remember, cloud provider have to compile with all the standards which are there in the world. Why I'm saying? Because cloud provider is not targeting only a certain group of customers. Cloud providers are targeting all the world, all the consumers which are there in the world there. And in this way, they have to also make sure that if they are providing solutions in India, they have to compile with a METI, which is one of the cloud standards available for that. If they are, you know, dealing with the European unions, they have to compile with GDPR, HIPAA and other standards there. And if they are dealing with some, payment gateway or some another things, PCI DSS. So provider have to compile with so many different standards and the regulations there. So some of the regulations and the standards we will be also discussing about, but again, some of them only. Because again, we are having lots of standards. So whatever the standards, which is very, very much common around us, that one also is going to be the key point of the domain number first. So overall, after ending the first domain, you will be having a great, deep understanding of the cloud, their service model, their deployment model. It means private, public, and obviously the hybrid cloud along with the community cloud as well. And then different concerns of each of the service model and the deployment model, and some of the best standards which we have to follow there while we are moving towards the cloud there. So this domain is going to provide you the proper foundation so you can move towards the next domain. Next domain is actually on the cloud data security. Now on the screen which you are seeing there are some new changes happen there. So that particular changes is also going to be included there, but let me discuss only the six key aspects there. Second domain is actually the cloud data security. I will be coming on the legal risk and compliance later. So second domain is on the cloud data security. Now, after understanding the different service model and the different deployment model, we will be discussing about the data part only. Remember, in the backend, we are using the same storage devices, whether it is the solid state disk or whether it is the magnetic hard drives. But over and all, when you're moving towards the cloud, you have to use different names for that one. Like we are having a new names like volume storage, we have object storage. And when we are dealing with the platform as a service, we might be using the structured storage, unstructured storage there. When we are dealing with the software as a service, we are having the direct portal access for the storage there. So in the cloud data security, first thing we will be discussing about what are the different type of storage options and what are the new names on the cloud. And after understanding those names, we will be discussing about the key technology which is going to help us to control and to implement the control actually. So in the cloud data security, we will be discussing about the different aspects of the data and the control there, like encryption again, IRM, information right management. Then we are going to discuss about, for the object of storage, how exactly the access over the data I'm going to provide it there. We will be discussing about the DLP solution on the cloud. We will be discussing about the, loggings of different type of storage whenever it is going to access by the users. And we are also going to discuss about a proper analytics features of the cloud there, through which we can analyze what exactly is happening there and how exactly we can continuously monitor this activity there. So cloud data security is going to provide you the proper access, proper view over the data part. And then based on that, we are going to look for the solutions there. We will be also discussing some of the new concept which is coming with the cloud data, and that is data dispersion. Then after, we will be also discussing about the one-way encryption, which is called as the homomorphic encryption in the cloud there. So over and all, after finishing this particular cloud data security, you will be having a deep understanding of the data security. So what are the different technology which we can implement to implement to provide the proper security to the data? Because all in all, the consumers are very much worried about how exactly the data is going to be processed on the cloud, because I am going to send my data to the cloud provider. And in that case, data is not going to be on my premises. And if it is not on my premises, it means we have to take care of the data properly. So all the possible solutions we have to implement. But remember, we have to balance the overall cost as well. We cannot use a control which is going way behind whatever the, you know, value of the data is. This is the reason we have to do the cost and benefit analysis. So we have to do the risk assessment. And after the risk assessment, we will be discussing which key control is going to best suitable for my data there. So this is what the discussion point of the cloud data security. After that, we will be discussing about the cloud platform and the infrastructure security. Now, in the cloud platform and infrastructure security, we are going to discuss about what exactly the platform composed of. Like when I'm talking about the service model, we have three service model: IaaS, PaaS, and SaaS. So infrastructure part and platform as a service part, we will be discussing in this particular module there. So what exactly the key components of the PaaS? What exactly the key component of the IaaS? And how exactly it's going to be integrated? It means from the architectural point of view, how exactly we need to design it there. And obviously for that, we will be discussing about some of the NIST guideline, which will help us to design the cloud aspect properly there. See, our main focus is also going to be from the examination perspective. So we will be discussing from all of the domain, how exactly we will be going to prepare for the examination. Because we have to understand what exactly the ISSQR is actually trying to ask you when you are going to sit in the examination, and how exactly you need to think. Because if you are aware about the ISSQR pattern for asking the questions, they are going to ask you the question which is going to be completely scenario based, and after that multiple answers can be the right one, but you have to select the best suitable answer based on the scenario there. So this is actually going to be the discussion point of the cloud platform and the infrastructure. So we will be having very much fun on the platform and the infrastructure along with the data security, because here we are going to talk from both of the point, administrative point and obviously the technical point there, which is going to provide you the deep understanding of the solutions. And based on that, we will be checking how exactly we as an architect, we have to provide the proper view over the solutions. So consumers can decide which option is actually going to best suits their requirement. After platform and infrastructure, we will be discussing about the application security, very much important point of the cloud there. Because over and all, our processing is going to done by the application only, but for that application to run, we require a proper platform. Like might be you are going to create a workload, or for running that particular application, you are creating a workload on the VM, or might be on the container. Might be you are using the serverless architecture, or might be you are going to use the microservices there. You can say proper functions as well there. In all of the cases, what are the key, what are the benefit and what are the demerits? That is what going to be the key part for us to discuss. Because application is only going to secure if the platform on which that application is running is going to secure there. And after discussing that platform, our focus is going to be on the application side. So when we are developing the application, when we are designing the application, when we are testing the application, when we are deploying the application, how exactly we can manage the whole life cycle of the application. And what are the key security aspects we have to look for when we are designing the application? Remember, we are not going to work as a developer, but at least as an architect, we can give our view over that application development. Like what are the application phases we have there? And what are the best processes we have to follow there? Now, process is actually going to make you better. So if you are integrating the proper process on the particular area, it is actually going to provide you the broader view. And based on that, you can implement the proper security over the application as well. We will be discussing about the microservices architecture. And in the microservices architecture, we are going to go into the deep dive in the Docker, container, and the orchestration of the container, which is called as the Kubernetes. How exactly it is going to help you in the application development and the design, and why we will be going for the Docker so much nowadays, that is also, and what are the key parts there. After discussing these points, we will be checking what are the key concerns of the application security. It means what are the different type of attack which can possible there, or you can say the risk. And based on that risk, what are the key solutions available around us? And how exactly we are going to map those key solutions with the application, that is also going to be our discussion point there in the application security part. So over and all, this is also going to be a very interesting package for us while we are going to, you know, look for that one. Application is a very critical point for any of the organization. Because we are moving into the cloud, the new risk is actually coming. Like now, the new risk is the cloud management plane. The new risk is the cloud APIs. New risk is the cloud services, which is actually going to handle by the provider. New risk is actually the data part as well there. So how exactly we are going to tackle those situations? What are the best practices available there? And what are some of the documentations we have to look for while creating a contract with a provider? That one too, we will be looking in this particular section. So again, application security is a very interesting point there. Now, after that, we will be moving towards the fifth domain, which is going to be on the cloud security operations. Now remember, this cloud security operations domain is actually this time discussing about the backend of the cloud. Backend in the sense the data center itself, where my all of the workloads are running. So when we are going to talk about the backend, it means how exactly the cloud providers is, you know, designing their data centers. What are the key components of the data centers and how exactly these solutions are going to work? What are the key aspects we have to look for while, you know, creating a contract with a cloud provider? Because ultimately, if the data center or you can say the platform is not secure, how can you say that your applications are going to be secure on the with the cloud provider? There might be multiple loopholes in the data center. So what are the key technologies the providers are using? And what are some of the best options we have to look for? See, as a consumer, we cannot enforce provider to use this technology or to use a particular certain technology there. But at least we can check whether it is actually compiling with my requirement or not. And if it is not, definitely I will be not selecting that provider. But at the same time, within the same domain, we will be also going to discuss from the management side. It means what exactly the change management process is, what exactly the problem management process is, what exactly the risk management process is, and which provider is handling what standard for all of these particular things. That is going to be the discussion point of the security operation, which is one of the, you know, broader view over the data center. And after that, the last domain is going to be on the cloud governance, or you can say the legal risk and the compliance, which is the sixth domain. So in this domain, we will be discussing about the different perspective of the legal challenges which a consumer can face there. And to tackle this, what are some of the concerned area that he have to look for? Like when we are going for the contract, how exactly we can look for the SLAs, compliance, and how exactly we can enforce our requirement. We will be also discussing about the different types of audit and how exactly those audit reports is going to be. One of the crucial documentation for the cloud is the CCM, cloud control metrics. So how exactly we will be investigating the cloud control metrics, and how exactly we are going to check the SOC 2 reports. What exactly the CAC reports are, Continuous Assessment Initiative questionnaire, and how exactly we are going to deal with these reports there as well. That too is going to discuss in point of the sixth domain. So this is what exactly the complete package of this particular CCSP course is. If I'm going for the weightage for the examination, the first domain is actually of 17% question. So in the examination, you'll be getting 17% of the question from the first domain. Second domain, which is the cloud data security, is you will be getting 19% of the question. So just if you are just selecting this cloud data security and legal, so legals, from the legal part you will be getting 13% of the question, and from the cloud data security part you will be getting 19% of the question. But excluding both of them, if I'm going to count other domains, all other domains are going to have a 17% of the weightage for the examination. So each domain, from each of the domain, you will be getting 17% of the questions there. So based on that, we are going to prepare for the examination, and obviously we'll provide you the correct view over this particular. So this is what the whole introduction of this particular course is. Let me know if you have any questions on this particular part.
Hello, Raj.
Yep. Hi, Richard.
Hi. Thank you so much for that, quite detailed information about the CCSP. All what you've said, wow. I think I'm excited, because I was looking at, doing this program or this course so that I can, switch from my current career or, profession as a software tester to becoming a cloud security architect or specialist. And while I was doing this research, the CCSP really appealed to me, because it touched on so many areas, which I think in today's technology, cloud is the way forward for, for many organizations. And so hence the reason why I thought, okay, I should embark on this. But again, I was looking for, a training provider, an instructor that is well informed around the subject area. And hence the reason why I made a request to Manish to, be in touch with you, with the instructor, to be able to give me, for me to understand, your background and also know what you'll be delivering as part of, this course. And for all what you've said so far, I am very much quite pleased and impressed with your vast experience, and so many of the areas which you touch on. I think for me, because I've been being a tester for the last 10 years, when you mentioned on testing and that we'll be doing actual sections on testing configuration on the virtual machines and touching all of the infrastructure as a service, PaaS as a service, software as a service, all of those, service models. I was excited. And the other fact that you'll be also touching on, the management side of things as well, I think, yes, I'm really looking forward to the course.
Thanks for watching the video. For full course, please visit www.igmguru.com and enroll today.